In the last video, I was talking about soil mineralization. And in this video, what I want to get into is something else that's very important for soil health, and that is organic matter. And organic matter sometimes can refer to something that is living, like roots are always growing and living, and leaves and plants. But mostly in this context, what I mean is something that used to be living. And so that is leaves that have fallen to the ground, that is snakes and beetles that are dead and lying on the ground, and other animals. It's it's microorganisms. It is all of these fresh things that have recently died and are lying on the ground. Then it's also the coarse mulch layer, if you can kind of see here, that is on the ground, which is when these things are starting to be broken down and they're becoming more like a mulch. They're being broken down by microorganisms. And then eventually when we get into the soil, we get into the humus layer, which is when these things have been broken down and broken down by all these different kinds of microorganisms, and it really resists being broken down anymore. It gets into the soil and it's called humus. So that's what we're going to be talking about today, is these forms of organic matter. The forest excels at recycling organic matter. The leaves from both deciduous and coniferous trees, which is the needles, are falling down, whether it be all in the fall for deciduous or often throughout the year for something that's coniferous, they're falling to the ground and they're being recycled. There are plants in the canopy underneath, if you get a shot of that, plants that just grow up every year and die back. And so that's a lot of organic matter. And then underground too, you have the roots that are, as you guys probably know, just as big as the upper part of a tree. The roots spread out all underground and, hey mosquito, don't go in my ear. All underground, and they actually grow and die back a lot. At a microscopic kind of level, they're always growing and dying and contributing organic matter. So a forest really excels at recycling all this organic matter into the soil. I should mention, although we don't have any prairies around us right now, that they create even more organic matter. You might not think so, but because the grasses, the grasses are very dense, they grow up and die every year. They have very dense root systems that grow and die a lot throughout the year. They create a lot of organic matter and it stays down in the soil, whereas in a forest, a lot of that carbon ends up in the trunks of these trees. But either way, in any kind of natural ecosystem, organic matter is being recycled very efficiently and it's doing a lot of good work in the soil. And that's just the plants. Of course, there are microorganisms, there are animals, earthworms, insects, all of these are growing and dying and they're being recycled back into the soil too. And what I want to talk about now is a few of the main things that organic matter does for us in the soil, in the forest, and in our gardens. First might be fertility. Organic matter, especially when it gets broken down into more humus in the soil, is exceptionally good at holding on to nutrients. So it stops nutrients from draining down out beneath where the roots can get them. It holds on to them and it makes them much easier for microorganisms and plants to use. It chelates with them, makes them much more available to all the other organisms. And further, organic matter is usually composed of a lot of nutrition itself. So of course, animals when they die, leaves when they fall, they have some nutrients in them. Many different minerals, but especially carbon, which we may not think of as a nutrient, but it's really one of the most common nutrients that plants need. They're made up of largely of carbon, so that's a very important nutrient for plants to take up, which they partially get from the air as carbon dioxide, but if there's lots of organic matter in the soil, they'll be happy to take it from there instead. Number two is water and air. Organic matter in the soil especially creates the different pore spaces that allow the soil to hold onto a lot of water, but also bigger pore spaces that allow it to hold onto a lot of air. So, all of our roots and our microorganisms need air, so we need that, and of course they need water, and so humus in the soil is good at that. Plus the coarse organic leaf layer on the top of the soil is really good at holding onto moisture and air as well. Then there's soil structure, which is partly what I just talked about with the air spaces and the water spaces, but also just the organic matter in the soil decreases compaction, really helps the soil bounce back from compaction, decreases erosion, it really helps the soil be held together instead of blowing away. Then there is providing for soil life, and really it's all the things I've just talked about, but organic matter is habitat for microorganisms and earthworms and insects, it's food, it's water, it's air, it just provides everything that all the soil food web needs to establish itself and be healthy. And it probably provides other things we don't know about on an energetic level, helping energy move through the soil, and just really, yeah, creating a community where soil life can thrive. We found the only sunny spot in this rainforest here. And now what I wanted to do is start talking about how we can mimic nature, this rainforest, to bring in organic matter into our gardens. And admittedly, some of the things we do are fairly unnatural, but they do help us speed up the process of getting organic matter into our soil and onto our soil. So the first would be compost. Composting is not really a natural process. We're kind of forcing very fast decomposition by bringing organic materials into a certain size pile with a certain amount of water and air and things like that, and certain combinations of materials in order to hasten the decomposition of that into organic matter and being on its way into humus. And we might use manure also in our garden, although it's really best composted first as well. So we bring that compost into our garden, and pretty quickly we have some fairly well broken down organic matter. The next thing is bringing in a mulch, which is so important for our garden. And the way we do it is the way nature does it, which is leaves. Leaves are by far the best mulch. I know that most people aren't using leaves, but they really are natural, they're nutritious, and they just provide many benefits. A little bit of grass clippings can work too. You don't want too thick of a layer of grass clippings because it can get anaerobic and promote the wrong kind of microorganisms, and it can smell and all that. But a little bit of grass clippings is fine. And when we don't have leaves or grass clippings, in the short term we can use straw, which works really well. It doesn't look quite as natural, but it does fine. But really what we hope is that we could eventually get some leaves into our garden. One thing that you really don't want to use too much of is bark mulch and wood chips. If we look at the forest floor here, you don't see 2 inches of wood chips or bark mulch. That's just not, you know, that's not how it happens. What you see here are mostly leaves. You see some sticks that fall. You know, hardly any bark because the trees don't shed bark all that much. You see probably some seeds and some fresh material, but it's mostly leaves that are coarse on top, and you get underneath and then they're more broken down. So you can use a little bit of that stuff. Bark mulch tends to, it can cause a nitrogen deficiency in your soil. It's so high in carbon that I won't explain it all here, but it can just cause nitrogen to be used up very quickly in your soil. The same with wood chips. And the thing about bark especially is that it has toxins in it. That's a plant's first line of defense against insects and other plant feeding organisms. And so there's toxins in bark, especially in coniferous bark that we often use in the garden, like fir and cedar. Pretty toxic stuff. Now you can use a little bit in an ornamental garden, or for example, if you have a cedar hedge, sure, you could use a little bit of cedar mulch underneath, but you don't need 2 inches of it. If you have a free source of woody material, again, in a deciduous, like an ornamental garden that's a woody garden, like shrubs and trees, a little bit can be okay. You might need to supplement some nitrogen, some organic nitrogen, so that you don't cause soil problems. But really, if you had a free source, I'd rather see you compost it for a few years and then bring it into your garden. So composts and mulches are a great way to quickly bring in organic matter. Sometimes we bring it in from off-site if we have to. But in the long run, what we really want to do is mimic nature even more by using, for example, plants. If we can plant things that grow quickly and make a lot of leaves that fall in, for most of us in the autumn, they fall, then that's a great way to create mulch, and then naturally it's going to become more humus over time. So planting things, always making sure we have ground cover, is a great way to mimic nature and increase organic matter. Along with that, we really want to have ground covers in our garden. And you can, they're very popular, it's very popular to use ground covers that are evergreen, like ivies, things like that. They can be helpful, but more I'm thinking deciduous ground covers like clovers and perennials that get recycled into the soil every year and improve the soil when they're recycled, and also improve the soil just by being there and covering it and protecting it. And speaking of clovers, if you're doing a lot of vegetable gardening where the bed is empty during the early spring and fall, it's great to plant a cover crop of legumes like clovers and vetches. They bring nitrogen into the soil, provide a lot of benefits, or sometimes grasses are good for, they bring in other benefits, but just always making sure your soil is covered in plants is a great way to make sure that it's always going to get, you know, a lot of organic matter. So you can see how nature gives us a lot of clues as to how to improve organic matter. In the long term, the sustainable way to do it is to plant a lot of plants that are going to be losing a lot of leaves and making a nice mulch for you. Having cover crops on the ground all the time, just always have the soil covered is a good way to do it. And then in the short term, we might bring in some compost and some leaf mulch, some straw mulch, to get that organic matter happening much more quickly. So that's really important. Step number two is organic matter. It does a lot for our garden. In the next video, I'm going to get into the third step to building a healthy garden ecosystem. As for all the things I talked about today, I do get into them in much more detail in the academy, in my online gardening course. So mulching and composting and cover cropping, all of that in a lot more detail. As I mentioned a couple of days ago, the price is going to be going up on Monday night. So if you're interested in that, you might want to have a look at that right now.